okay, that is up to here. Page number 77, first paragraph. Up to the page number 77, first paragraph, you are having the examination. Okay, that is that means you have to study about okay, the introduction and Mendel's laws of inheritance 5.1. Okay, what is the experimental material, contrasting traits, characters, contrasting traits, inheritance of one gene, okay, experimental procedure, okay, what are genes, what are alleles, how to represent these genes, dominant, recessive, monohybrid cross, okay, and next, the probability of monohybrid cross, pest cross. Okay, and next loss. Okay, the loss of Mendel based upon monohybrid cross, the law of dominance, law of segregation, incomplete dominance, and next explanation of the concept of dominance up to here.
Twenty marks, sir.
What will keep? Will keep for 20 marks or 30 marks?
20, sir.
20 is enough. Okay. We'll have 20 MCQs and that will be in the tomorrow morning at 6:30. Okay. The link will be shared. Tomorrow morning 6:30. The link will be shared and you can attend for the examination. Okay. By using the link. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Anything? Anybody is having any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Then coming to our topic. Okay. In the last class, we have discussed about a dihybrid cross. That means here the Mendel has selected two characters. One is a seed color and the second one is a seed shape. Seed color and seed shape. Seed color, okay, seed color, that is yellow and green. Yellow is dominant and green is recessive, and seed shape, round is dominant and wrinkled is recessive. How we can understand means when we crossed the parents with the homozygous for color. Homozygous dominant, when a homozygous dominant for a seed shape and seed color is crossed with a homozygous recessive for a seed shape and seed color, in the F1 generation, we got all dominant individuals showing round and yellow seeded plants. So from this, we came to understand that among round and wrinkled, round is dominant, and among yellow and green, yellow is dominant over the green color seeds. So, and next, to obtain the F2 generation, he selfed the F1 hybrids to obtain the F2 generation. In the F2 generation, okay, in the F2 generation, we can see here, okay, that means as the organism is heterozygous for the two traits, so the number of gametes, types of combinations of gametes is four in number. So four gametes of male and four different gametes of female, okay, can randomly fuse. As a result, we can get 16 individuals. 4 into 4, 16 individuals we can get. Out of the 16 individuals, when you observe the phenotypic ratio, as represented as 9:3:3:1. 9 are round yellow, okay, and 3 are round green. Okay, and next 3 are wrinkled yellow, and next 1 is a round green. Okay, that means they are obtained in the ratio, the phenotypic ratio wrinkled of dihybrid cross is wrinkled green. 1 wrinkled green, Okay, so when you observe the phenotypic ratio of dihybrid cross is 9:3:3:1. 9 round yellow, 3 round green, 3 wrinkled yellow, 1 wrinkled green. Okay, and in the same manner, when you observe the genotypic ratio, the genotypic ratio of dihybrid cross is given as 1:2:1, 2:4:2, 1:2:1. Okay, this is the dihybrid genotypic ratio. Okay, we'll get 4 ones, 4 twos, and 1 4. We can observe in the, okay, in this checkerboard, we can observe all the genotypic combinations that are present in this straight line, all they are present as 1. Capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y, 1. Small R, capital Y, capital Y, 1. Capital R, small y, 1. And small y, 1. And when you observe, okay, the capital R, capital Y is 2. We can see here. And at the same time, capital R, capital Y, small y are also 2 in number. And next, small r, capital Y, small y are also 2 in number. And next, capital R, small y are also 2 in number. Whereas, capital R, capital Y, small y are 4 in number. So that is the genotypic ratio, which is given as 1:1:1:1:2:2:2:4. That is the genotypic ratio of a dihybrid cross. And next, okay, the Mendel has proposed two laws based upon the monohybrid cross, law of dominance and the law of segregation. In the similar manner, after observing the results of F2 ratio, F2 of a dihybrid cross, he proposed a third law of inheritance, or third Mendel's law. Okay, that is called as a law of independent assortment. What this independent assortment is explaining means, when you observe here, okay, when you observe the phenotypic ratio, the phenotypic ratio is 9:3:3:1. 9 are round yellow, 3 are round green, and 3 are wrinkled yellow, and 1 is wrinkled green. Okay, when you observe here, when you observe the round yellow, which are 9 in number, and wrinkled green, which is only 1. This round yellow and wrinkled green are parental combinations. Because what are the characters we have selected while we are undergoing dihybrid cross means round yellow is crossed with wrinkled green. These are the parental combinations. Okay, that means 9+1, 10. 10 are parental combinations. But when you observe the middle two, that is round green and wrinkled yellow, which are 3 in number each. Okay, when you observe these are not parental combinations. Okay, we don't find any parent with round green. We didn't observe any parent with wrinkled yellow in the parental generation. We observed only round yellow and wrinkled green. Okay, those two only we crossed and we obtained round and yellow in the F1 generation. Only in the F2 generation only we got round green and wrinkled yellow of 3 each. Okay, the reason for this is because of the independent assortment. That means at the gamete formation, the segregation of one pair of alleles is independent of the other pair of allele. Okay, that means we can't say every time, R will pair up with Y. Okay, capital R always pairs with the capital Y. Sometimes the capital R is also pairing with the small y also during the gamete formation. We can see not always pairing with the capital Y. Capital R is also pairing with the small y also. Why? Because of the segregation of these alleles is taking place independently. That means they are assorting independently and they are combining independent. The combining of one allele is independent of the other allele. As a result, we are getting 4 different types of gametes, and these 4 different gametes are fusing. We are getting 16 different individuals. Okay, and this is explained. Okay, the presence of this two new combinations along with the parental combinations is well explained with the help of this third inheritance law that is called the law of independent assortment. Okay, this law of independent assortment is purely explained based upon the dihybrid cross. We can't explain with cross, my monohybrid cross. With the help of monohybrid cross, we can't explain this independent as law of independent assortment. Why? Because in a monohybrid cross, we are getting either okay dominant individuals or recessive individuals of the parental combinations only. Okay, for example, if we take tall and dwarf, we are getting tall and dwarf plants in the F2 generation. We are not getting any other characters. If we take axial and terminal flower, we'll get an axial and terminal flower. Some plants with axial and some plants with the terminal. There are no other choice. But when you are observing with the dihybrid cross, along with the parental combination, some new combinations are also getting. These are called recombinations. Okay, these are new combinations which we are observing, like a round green, okay, wrinkled yellow. These are new combinations. We are calling it as recombinations. Because new combinations that are observed in the F2 generation of dihybrid cross. Okay, to explain the reason behind that, okay, they introduced this law called the law of independent assortment. That's what we can see here. In the dihybrid cross, the phenotypes are round yellow, wrinkled yellow, round green, and wrinkled green appeared in the ratio 9:3:3:1. Such a ratio was observed for several pairs of characters that Mendel studied, not only with the seed color and seed shape, even if he has taken with the stem height and flower position, even if he has taken a pod shape and pod color, in that case also he observed the similar results of 9:3:3:1 ratio. So here we can see the ratio of 9:3:3:1 can be derived as a combination theories of three yellow with one, with three round, one wrinkled. Okay, three yellow, one green, with three round and one wrinkled. This derivation can be written as follows. So, three round, one wrinkled. Okay, three yellow, one green. That is, that means it is a combination of two monohybrid cross. Okay, that is seed color and seed shape. So we have combined the monohybrid cross of seed shape and the monohybrid cross of seed color. Okay, that is given as 3:1:3:1. When you the product of these two monohybrid cross is given as 9:3:3:1. 9 round yellow, 3 wrinkled yellow, 3 round green, 1 green. Okay, based upon such observations on dihybrid crosses between plants differing in two traits, Mendel proposed a second set of generalizations that we call Mendel's law of independent assortment. Okay, that means second set of generalizations. Okay, the first two laws comes under the first set of generalization of Mendel's laws, and this law of independent assortment will comes under second set of generalization of Mendel's laws. Okay, what this law states? Okay, the law states that when two pairs of traits are combined in a dihybrid, segregation of one pair of character is independent of the other pair of character. Okay, that means the separation of one pair of trait is independent of the other pair of the trait. Okay, the law states that when two pairs are in a hybrid, segregation of one pair of characters is independent of the other pair of characters. So that's why what happened? We are not only getting the parental combinations, we are getting some new combinations or recombinations in the F2 generation, like a round green and wrinkled yellow. Okay, So how it is possible? That is explained here. The Punnett square can be effectively used to understand the independent segregation of two pairs of genes during meiosis and the production of eggs and pollen in the F1 or capital R, small r, capital Y, small y plant. Okay, consider the segregation of one pair of genes, capital R and small r. Okay, so 50% of the gametes have gene capital R and other 50% have small r. Now, each gamete having either capital R or small r, it should also have the allele capital Y or small y. So the important thing to remember here is the segregation of 50% capital R and 50% small r is independent from the segregation of 50% capital Y and 50% small y. Therefore, 50% of small r bearing gametes have capital Y and the 50% has a small y. Similarly, 50% of the capital R bearing gametes have capital Y and other 50% have small y. Thus, there are four genotypes of gametes. So we'll get four different types of pollen grains and four different types of eggs. Okay, with the capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small y. Like this, we'll get four different genotypes. Why? Because for each allele, because they are heterozygous for both the traits. That is seed color and seed shape. So that is the capital R, small r is there. Capital Y, small y is there. So the chance of production of 50% of the gametes with the capital R, 50% of the gametes with the small r. And at the same time, this is capital R and small r has to also combine with the capital Y and small y also. Capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y. And at the same time, small r also has to combine with the capital Y. And at the same time, small r also has to combine with the small y also. So which totally we'll get four genotypes of gametes. Okay, of pollen as well as the egg also. That's why we are getting four different types of gametes. That is the four types are capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, Y, each with a frequency of 25% or 1/4 of the total gametes produced. Okay, so when you observe the probability, okay, when you observe the probability, we can see here. So one by two capital R at the same time, one by two small r. Okay, and this capital R will has to fuse with a one by two capital Y. 1/2 all y. Understand? So when these two, it will be okay, 1/2 into 1/2, that is 1/4 capital R capital Y. When these two combine, one by four. Okay, here also 1/4 capital R small y. Here also we can observe one by two capital Y, 1/2 then what we'll get, here also 1/4 small r capital Y, 1/4. All are small y. So totally we are getting 4 different types of gametes. Okay, 4 different types of gametes we are getting. Okay, of 25% each, 1/4 means 25%. Okay, 25% capital R capital Y, 25% capital R small Y, 25% small R capital Y, 25% small R small Y. Okay, not only with the male. Not only with the male, female also the same type of gametes are produced. Same. Okay, now these two, okay, 4 gametes will fuse randomly. Okay, because of this random fusion of the different gametes with the different, different gametes of male with the different gametes of female. Okay, we are not only getting the parental combinations in the F2 generation of dihybrid, we are getting some new combinations. Okay, like, round green and wrinkled yellow. Okay, this new combinations we are calling it as a recombinants. And this recombinants is because of the law of independent assortment. That is what he is saying. So you can see. Can you use the Punnett square data to work out the genotypic ratio of at the F2 stage and fill in the format given? Okay, is the genotype ratio also 9:3:1? Okay, the genotypic ratio as is a 1:2:1, 2:4:2, 1:2:1. So genotypes are found in F2 and their expected phenotype. The table you have to prepare. So capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. What is the phenotype? Round yellow. Capital R, small R, capital Y, small Y. What is the phenotype? Round yellow. Small R, capital Y, capital Y. Okay, wrinkled yellow. Okay, capital R, small R, capital Y, capital Y. Capital R, small Y, small Y. Like that, different genotypes. Once if you check the Punnett square, you can observe the different genotypes. Okay, this genotypes and their phenotypes, you have to write, okay, prepare a table. Okay, prepare a table. Understand? Anybody is having any doubt regarding the dihybrid cross? Having any doubt regarding this dihybrid cross? Okay, again, I
sir, one second, it half R, half small R, that one, sir.
Yes, ma'am, for a probability, you want probability?
Yes, sir.
I will explain. Okay. 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 Okay, this is okay. These are male gametes and these are the female gametes. Okay, for suppose you can say. So we can observe. Okay, 4 4 16. So 1/16. 1/16 of the individuals. Okay, here capital R is there, no? So that one we can take capital R, capital Y. This is one genotype. So out of 16 individuals, one individual will be having a capital R, capital Y. What is the phenotype? Round, comma yellow. That is the phenotype. Okay, now in the same manner, the second one also. We can see 1/16. 1/16. What a second combination. Capital R, capital Y, small Y. Capital R, capital Y, small Y. What is the phenotype here? The same. Round yellow.
Round yellow.
Round yellow. Okay. And next, the third one. 1/4 capital Y. 1/4. Small R, capital Y, the third one we have to take. So when you observe here, what we'll get? 1/16. 1/16. Capital R, small R. And next, capital Y. What is the phenotype here? Round yellow. Round yellow. And next, again, capital R, capital Y, small R, small Y. So 1/16, 4 4 16 now. So we are saying 1/16, capital R, small R, capital Y, small Y. What is the phenotype here also? Round yellow. Understand? That is for one. We have to take with the other one also. Taken. Okay. So this one. These four. Now we can get 1/16. 1/16, what we'll get? Okay, capital R, small Y. Okay, here we can get capital R, capital Y, small Y. So capital R, capital Y, small Y. What is the phenotype? Round yellow. One by 16, again, next one. 1/16, here, okay, here capital R is there. Here capital R. Here small y. So we'll get, what is the genotype? Capital R, small y. So what is the phenotype here? Capital R is there now, so round, but small y, so green. 1/16. Next, the third one. What is the third one? Capital. Okay, here capital R is there. Here small r is there. Here capital Y is there. Here small y. So the combination will be capital R, small r. Capital Y, small y. And the phenotype is round yellow.
Yellow.
Round yellow. Okay, now. And now we'll go with the fourth one. What is the fourth one? capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, small y. So that is the combination we'll get. So 1/16. 1/16, capital R, small r, small y, small y.
Small y, small
what
y.
Is the phenotype? What is the phenotype here? Round.
Round green.
Wrinkled. Sorry. Round green. Round green. Okay. Okay, this is for the second one. So how many organisms we have got? 8. Like that, the other one also. Okay, now again, 1/16. Here we can take 1/16. 1/16, capital, okay, here is small r, here capital R. So we'll write a capital R, small r, and next capital Y, capital Y. What is the gene phenotype? Round, yellow. Okay, and next 1/16. Here is a small r, here capital R. Capital Y, small y. Capital R, small r. Capital Y, capital Y. The genotype, okay, what is the phenotype? Round, yellow. Next one, 1/4. 1/16. Okay, here it is small r, here also small r. Here capital Y, here also capital Y. So, small r, capital Y, capital Y. What is the, that means wrinkled?
Wrinkled yellow.
Okay, wrinkled yellow. The same manner, the fourth one combination. 1/16. What is the combination here? Small r, capital Y, small y. R, small r, capital Y, small y. Okay, what is the phenotype here? Wrinkled?
Yellow.
Yellow. Okay, this four combinations completed. And again with this also. Last one. Okay, here also we'll get 1/16. 1/16. Okay, here small r. Okay, here small r is there. Here capital R is there. So what we'll write? Capital R, small r. Okay, here small y is there. Capital Y is there. So we can write capital Y, small y. Okay, what is the phenotype? Round, yellow. And next, 1/16. What is present here? Small r, here capital R. Here small y, here small y. So, capital R, small y. What is the okay phenotype? Round, small y, green. In the same manner, we can say it. 1/16. Here, small r is there. Here also small r. Here small y, here capital Y. So we can write small r, capital Y, small y.
Wrinkled yellow.
Okay, the phenotype is wrinkled yellow. And next the last one. 1/16. What here? Small r. Here small y, small y. So all are smalls. Small r, small r, small y, small y. So it is wrinkled.
Wrinkled green.
Wrinkled green. That is what you will get. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now what happened? Okay, what we have done to obtain the individuals, we have undergone product. That means we multiplied. Now what happens? In this, there are some similar ones are also there. So how many round yellows are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 round yellows are there. Phenotypic ratio, you got it now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and next, how many round green are there? 1. Next, where? Round green, where we find? Okay, we can see here, round green. These are all round green. Okay, the red color ones. And next, okay, so 9. And next, how many round yellow, okay? Wrinkled yellow came. Wrinkled yellow, you can see here. This one alone in a different color. Okay, now we can see. Okay, 4. Okay, you can see here. All the round yellow are in black color. Okay, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 1, 9. So 9 are round yellow. And okay, that is the ratio. Okay, we can see here. 9 is 2. And next, how many round green? 1, 2, 3. 3 is 2. And next, how many wrinkled yellow? 1, 2, 3. Blue color. You can see here. And next, how many wrinkled green? Okay, this violet color, 1. So the phenotypic ratio, we have got it now. In the same manner, the genotypes also we can take. Okay, we can also take into consideration the genotypes. The genotypes which are in the similar color, we can see. Okay, capital R, capital Y, okay, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. They are only one in color. There is no other ones, only one. If you take a capital R, capital Y, small y, then you observe this one will be 2 in number, we can see. Capital R, capital Y, small y, here it is there, no? Okay, here also we can see. Capital R, small r, capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y.